plan for the future. I live for right now.
I don't think they want to interrupt my party. Please don't interrupt my party. We just trying to find somebody for the night. I don't think they want to interrupt my party. Please don't interrupt my party. We just trying to find somebody. Up, wake up, up, wake up, up, wake up, up, wake up.
Here with my guy Greg, aka Mr. Smack, aka Mr. Smackington. He is here looking fresh, ready to go. We are off another stellar NFL week. Listen, guys, if you are not following our NFL picks, you guys are doing something wrong. We are smashing NFL. Seriously, this might be my best season in NFL ever. My October run has been lights out, unbelievable. If you haven't followed me on Juice Reel, you need to be. The link is below. You'll get all of my best bets right there. Greg's will be there soon, too. We're getting him all set up there as well. But if you aren't following me on Juice Reel, like I said, you're doing something wrong. NFL in October. Ready for this, Greg? 146-43. That is my record for October, up 17.4 units. College football, 76-23. Just an unreal record right now. And, you know, we are, you know, smashing books left and right. For the week, we did pretty well. NFL 20-11 for the week, plus 6 units. And yeah, we just continue to crush. So that's what we're doing. Greg was killing his best bets last week. He's been smashing baseball. Hockey's now started. NBA started. This is like Christmas for bettors. It's a busy time of year for everybody with every sport going. So, Greg, how are you? How's your week been? You ready to dive into Thursday night football?
Yeah, man, you already know everything going good. I got some other shit going besides this Thursday night football, but we're going to kick off on this Thursday night football. For sure.
This is a great matchup.
Yeah, this is a nice NFC matchup right here. Going to LA, you know, the weather should be a little nice, you know what I'm saying? So we should see some shit today.
Yeah, two quarterbacks who came into the league projected to be the best ever, as always, you know, Sam Darnold taking on Matthew Stafford. Sam Darnold, you know, a real resurgence in his career. You know, he's now in Minnesota, and he was kind of sent off to no man's land in the cold north. That is Minnesota, and he has really revived his career. He's been lights out. Currently, he's got 12 touchdowns, 5 interceptions in 6 games. Minnesota just ran for 139 yards last week. They are really, you know, have been playing some lights out football. I mean, lost their first. Last week was their first loss, and it was a close one, 31-29. I didn't end up taking anyone in that game. I could have had Detroit. I could have had Minnesota. I ended up taking Minnesota on an 11-team parlay, and that was the only one that lost. Oh, wow. I would have hit for 3,500. And, didn't listen to myself and went against my first instinct, but that's something you shouldn't do.
It was still a good bet, man. You never know.
Yeah, you know what? I'm not mad at it. It was close. Yeah. It was that game. If there could not have been more of a toss-up game for the week.
I tell people all the time, don't beat yourself up about a post-game performance. You didn't know. Yep. If that's not what you saw, that's not what you saw. Don't be mad because you thought you should have did something else. You know, stick with your gut. Trust yourself. Take that ass whooping like a man or a woman.
we'll get him on the next one, right?
We'll get him on the next one, my boy.
Yeah, that's how it goes. We are going to break down this Thursday night football game, give you guys some of our favorite plays for tonight. Then we'll have a full show for the Sunday slate coming out tomorrow. And keep an eye out for some basketball, NHL videos, soccer, all that great stuff. We're going to be ramping up the content here for you guys to get you more best bets all day long right here on the Pick Management Network. So, Greg, why don't you go ahead and dive into this Thursday night football matchup between the Vikings and the Rams. Vikings currently 2.5-point favorites, minus 150 on the money line, over-under set at 47.5.
Well, for me, I'm a bet365 guy. If anyone's on bet365, I guarantee you, you should love it like me. They got some good stuff for you. But for me, it's at +3 and at over 48, under 48, whatever. Who cares? We don't. It's just a number. Let's just get right into it, all right? Like we said, we're going to be in Southern Cal today. Okay, the weather should be kind of nice, all right? People should have themselves a good little time out there in SoFi Stadium. With that being said, this is what I see happening, okay? Like we was just talking about the Vikings and the Lions. First Vikings loss. It was probably one of them games that needed to happen for the Vikings to come back down to earth for a second. They didn't really play totally out of sync. I'm going to just say the defense was just outmatched. Let's just say they were just outmatched with Jahmyr Gibbs and David Montgomery sticking to them. And Jared Goff was looking like he was just on a mission for that defense to tear it apart. But that's neither here nor there with today. All right, Minnesota, I love to see them bounce back a little bit, especially on the defensive tip. And their quarterback threw a pick last week, which I took. I took Sam Darnold to throw a pick last week. I called that. Goff, he was playing. Them boys just couldn't hold the ball. He had one for me, too, but Minnesota fluked on me. That's why they DBs, not wide receivers. This week, though, we're going to take Stafford to throw a pick, all right? He has thrown a pick his last three starts. And the Vikings, like I say, I believe that they're going to pounce a little bit better on these weak wide receivers coming out from the Rams. Cooper Kupp's first game back. Puka Nacal might be his first game back. I don't expect neither one of them to be heavy targeted, but they should be decoyed enough to fuck up some type of a flop pass, and Stafford's going to throw one on a bat down. I don't care how he throws it, he's going to throw one. All right, I definitely.
You know, the Rams, I mean, not the Rams, the Vikings are lead the league right now in blitz rate this season at 43%.
Yeah, they're going to cost him to do a stupid play. It's going to be a turnover. All right, y'all mess with that. Stafford, he throwing a pick. You hear me? Next, since you was just talking about how the Vikings is rushing on them blitzes, I love, absolutely love this game to go over in total sacks. It's at 5.5, all right? Last game, the Vikings and the Lions was almost at like 9 sacks combined on both sides. Vikings is going to get to Stafford, all right? They will get on that ass. Now, also with Sam Darnold, he's not the fastest QB in the world. Even though we know that the Rams' front line ain't the same since Sam Darnold left, I expect him to hit that turf at least 3 times himself.
Well, you know, Sam Darnold, I'll tell you, sorry to interrupt, he has taken a sack on 25% of his pressures this season, which is like way above the league average. So,
pocket passes, they're going to give you that sack, you know.
Yep.
Sometimes they don't want to sit there and get out the pocket, and he's not really a mobile quarterback. So, that's why I say I expect him to hit that dirt at least 3 times. So, that's the second play. Is total sacks over for the game. It's at 5.5 right now, currently on Bet365. Next, okay, the Rams defense, all right, their secondary to me is just beyond boo-boo, all right? They have been allowing at least 21-plus points in every game but their last game versus the Raiders. And like I say, due to the fact how Vikings just lost, I expect them to come out crazy nasty with the offensive game. And I'm loving Sam Darnold here to drop 2 passing touchdowns on y'all. Okay, in so far, he going to come out. Sam Darnold in the end zone, all right? Count him for 2. Okay, that's the third play I got for the SGP for y'all. Fourth play, we know Stafford. He's still Stafford, all right? Due to the fact, we know the Vikings, they're going to pass rush and everything, which is going to allow Stafford to try to get the ball out on quick little slants or a little hook and ladder type of plays. And some of them over there are going to get some good yak, all right, yards after catch. I'm going to take Stafford to get his passing yards over, okay, on the Vikings, all right? It's going to be a lot of quick throws. It's going to be a lot of, you know, 5 and 6 yard gains, whatever. He's getting that ball out of his hands, all right? That running back over there for the Rams, he's going to play a lot of think of the word, you know, but he gonna get some passes out the backfield. I expect Stafford to get his passing yards over on the Vikings. That's all he can.
239.5.
Yeah, that's all he can do. Even with the pick he gonna throw, that's all they really got right now. He has to try to keep this offense moving the ball. Fourth play.
Yeah, you know, this Rams offense ranked at 20th. You know, they look like they should be better, but they're like on paper, but they're not. But we haven't mentioned yet. They are getting Cooper Kupp back this week. Puka Nacua is looking like he should be returned. So this should be for first time, you know, the first healthy Rams team. You know, they might be slow to introduce these guys back into the system, but, you know, Stafford's now got his guys back. So
that's what I'm thinking.
Now we're talking about it. So, yep.
That's why I said,
sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
They're not highly targeted. No, no, you're good. I was going to say, at the very least, if they're not highly targeted, they're still going to be great decoys. Somebody will be open with two extra assets on the floor for Stafford, okay? So, yeah.
You know, part of the reason why I like your interception pick so much for Stafford is because those guys are back. You know, guys coming back, haven't played, I don't think, all season long, really. You know, maybe a little slow off the start, maybe not the most accurate route run, something like that might happen, you know, tip ball from that. You know, that's why I see the interception more than anything, is because they're going to be, you know, running some stuff that they haven't run all season yet. And, you know, that's when mistakes can happen.
Yeah, man. Like I said, I ain't going to lie. He definitely going to give one up, man. Shout out to my boy Steve Allen, man. He loved the Vikings. And right now the Vikings doing him justice this year. So I know he's going to be ready for them boys to bounce back and pass on the Rams. But I still feel Stafford going to get them yards, all right? And the last play that I have for this game is a little bit of something on both sides. Like I said, it's going to be one of them ones that's a bad pass was thrown. But like I said, the Vikes defense should step back up. I don't see the Rams getting heavily offense into the end zone. They're going to get maybe a touchdown or two, but I'm also loving the field goals over 3.5 for both sides. I just think probably Rams end up getting more field goals than the Vikings, but who knows? It's going to be a little floppy in the red zone. But I definitely know this game is also my last play. It's going to go over, which is the total number, just merely because, like I said, the Vikings should want to come into this game trying to dominate. Due to the fact, like I said, they're going to let Stafford give up his passing yards. They're going to get down there. It's just no question of how they're going to look getting into the end zone. But I still like the Vikings to probably more so dominate this game and to force it to go over.
I love it. Love all that stuff from Mr. Smack, a.k.a. Greg. You know, he always drops some real gems for us here on the Pick Management Network. You know, he did break down most of this game. I just got to – excuse me. A couple other points. You know, Sam Darnold, former first-round draft pick, 27 years old now, is in the best offensive, you know, system of his life. And, you know, I think with going 5-1 so far this year, he's really let people know that he means business. And he's taken advantage of where he's at. You know, he was former, Jets QB, and that was
the Jets. He had no wideouts there either. He had no line.
Yeah, he didn't have. There was nothing there for him. You know what I mean?
Well, he was a top college QB for a reason because he had protection.
Right.
Now we're seeing what he looks like with protection.
And now, you know, when he was at the Jets, you know, he didn't have success on the field, but I think one thing he did get was an education, and he learned how to elevate his game and what it takes to be one of those top tier quarterbacks. And now he has the ability to do that because he's got some weapons around him. So. You know, like I said, Darnold, 12 touchdowns, 5 interceptions, 6 games. Stafford, only 3 touchdowns all season long. The Rams, 2-1 on the 2-1 ATS at home, 0-3 on the road. And McVay, 5-2 ATS on 4 days rest. Right now, 80% of the bets is on Minnesota. But the line has still continued to move towards the Rams. Even with all that public money, the public has been right on these really lopsided bets the past few weeks. Public's been hot in their picks. If you follow, you know, where the money's going and how the line moves based on that. But I do have a couple of plays here. You know, I don't have a real winner picked out. I think it's going to be close. I think it's going to be, you know, 3 points either way. So I'm staying away from a winner, but I like over 46. I'm minus 145. That's what my system has it at. So I'm going to play my number. A little juicy, but you know what they say. I'm sorry, if you don't know what they say, sometimes the juice is worth the squeeze, but that's a story for another day. Rams plus 5.5 and over 42.5. That is a pre-built parlay on Bovada, which is where I play. So if you're playing at somewhere else, it's probably going to have to be a same game parlay. So Rams plus 5.5, over 42.5, plus 120. I think Justin Jefferson, ATS, anytime score minus 120. Let me tell you about Justin Jefferson so far this season. He has played in 6 out of the 7 games and has touchdowns in 5 of those games. He's at 81 yards, 92, 85, 81, 133, and 59. But he's just been seriously a monster. Receptions, 7, 6, 6, 6, 4, and 4. So he's just been eating all day long, every game. I don't think it's
going to be different. Jefferson's yards over is probably a lock today, too.
Yeah, I like that, too. Jefferson's yards, let me tell you what his yards over are. Sorry.
It's probably at 88, somewhere around there.
Steven Props, Jones, Jefferson, 83 and a half.
You know what I'm saying?
So, he's only gone over this three times. Yeah, he's gone over this 3 times this season. If you want to take a stab at it, I wouldn't be mad at you because it's definitely possible in a game like this, which I think is going to be pretty much back and forth.
Yeah, this would be the game to do it in.
After we just said all that about all the offense in this game that we're expecting and whatnot, I'll tell you, there's going to be some offense in this game, but, Minnesota, 19th ranked defense, Rams, 27th ranked defense, Minnesota, 13th ranked offense, Rams, 20th ranked offense. So, we think there's going to be some electricity in this game. It's going to be a little, going to be electric, but, I say that cautiously. One thing I do think is going to happen is, we do like Cooper Kupp to come into this game and make a difference, but I still took his receiving yards under. It's 67 and a half. A guy like him, first game back, with him, I think it's either feast or famine with Cooper Kupp, even when he's 100%, and I don't think he's 100% here. And I think that, he'll get some yards, but I don't think he's going to be as much of a weapon here. I think it's going to be like more of what you said, that he's going to be more of a decoy in this game than anything. So I did take Kupp under 67 and a half. And you guys know me. I love sweetheart teasers. I cash them every single week. It is like a, really like a free bet that the books give you. It's either, if it's more than 2 teams, you can get 13 points, 2 touchdowns. That is a massive amount of points in the NFL. Or if it's less than, 2 teams, you can get up to 9 points. So I played a 9-point sweetheart teaser, minus 185, the Rams plus 11.5 and over 38.5. And then I played the other side, Minnesota plus 6.5 and over 38.5. It takes us through every single key number there is. I think it's going to be a very close game. I don't think anyone wins by more than a touchdown here. So I think both teams will be within the number. And I think we see like a 24-21 type finish here. Some touchdowns, but not like a 35-30 game. I don't think it's going to be that. I think it's going to be low 20s.
It's got to be higher. It's got to be.
I hope so, but if these guys aren't as prepared as we are expecting coming back from injury, I think Rams could be in trouble here. And I think it's more so of the Rams scoring less than Minnesota. Minnesota's been eaten and can do that. I think the Lions are better than the Rams, and we saw what they did last week. So, just a little projection. Greg, Smack, you want to recap your plays?
Sure, I'll recap. We got the sacks over 5.5.
Yep.
We got Sam Darnold to throw over 1.5 passing touchdowns.
Mm-hmm.
We got Stafford's passing yards over.
Yep.
We have the game to go over.
Uh-huh.
And we have over 3.5 field goals combined. I believe that's everything.
All right. And where can people find you?
Find me on X, Mr._Smackington. Or you can find me on Instagram. Just go to the search bar, type in Smackington, and I'll pop right on up.
And this week, we will have him set up on a service so you can get all of his plays sent right to your phone. He will be all set up totally with the Pick Management Network. My best bets are over 46, Rams plus 5.5, and over 42.5, Justin Jefferson, anytime touchdown, Cooper Kupp under 67.5, and 2 9-point sweetheart teasers, Rams plus 11.5 and over 38.5, Minnesota plus 6.5 and over 38.5. I'm Jacob, also known as Pick Management. You guys can find me across all socials at Pick Management. You can also find me on Juice Reel and Winnable. You know, a couple different things going on in each one of those, so make sure you check both out. The links are below. We will be back later with a full Sunday slate show, breaking down every single game, giving you our best bets and more. We'll also be around with some NHL and NBA free plays. Crushed last night's full first night, 4-2. Had a great start to the NBA. If you don't know, Greg is a beast in basketball. That is where he crushes. And he's very good at hockey, too. So keep an eye out on all of his socials and all of mine as well. That'll do it for us here today at the NFL Betting Insiders. We will see you later. You came to prepare for the future. I live right now.